When using the for loop, you have the option of looping over a collection, rather than using a range object. Let's take a look at an example. I'm in VS Code, and I've already created a new .jl file. I've also launched the Julia REPL by using Alt-J, then Alt-O. In addition, I've docked my REPL window next to my editor. Let's start by setting up a small array to use as an example. To loop over the elements in this array, you can use a for loop. But rather than using a range object, you can use the syntax for element in collection. The variable name for the element can be any name, but the collection name has to refer to an existing collection. In this example, the name of the collection is myArray. Also notice that the word in is used, rather than the equal sign character. In Julia, when using a for loop, you have the option of using either the equal sign character or the word in. By convention, when creating a for loop in Julia, the equal sign character is used with a range object, and the word in is used to loop over a collection. But they do the same thing inside of a for loop, so in practice, you'll see the equal sign character and the word in used interchangeably by Julia developers. This is optional, but I'm going to clear my REPL window by using Ctrl-L. And then I'm going to use Shift-Enter to run this code. In the REPL, you'll see the elements of the array displayed. You can use this concept to loop over other types of collections in Julia. For example, in Julia, a string is just a collection of individual characters, so you can loop over a string as well. Before hitting Shift-Enter, I'm going to clear my REPL window by using Ctrl-L. And then I'm going to hit Shift-Enter in the editor. In the REPL, you'll see all of the individual characters in the string displayed in a column. Pretty cool, right? You can also use this concept to loop over the keys and the values in a dictionary. For the variable names for the key value pairs, use a tuple when creating the for loop. Like before, I'm going to clear my REPL window by using Ctrl-L. And then I'm going to hit Shift-Enter in the editor. In the REPL, you'll see a nicely formatted display of the key value pairs in this dictionary. In summary, the for loop is both an efficient and versatile version of the repeated evaluation control flow tool. You can use it either with a range object, or you can use it to loop over a collection. But since conditional statements are not involved, you should use a for loop only if you know in advance how many times you want your computer to repeat a task. So that's the basics of using a for loop to loop over a collection without using a range object. This concludes the mini-series on control flow in Julia. In the next chapter, you'll learn what a comprehension is and how to use it in Julia.